Don't talk about Wingspan. Don't talk about Wingspan. Don't talk about Wingspan.
We're recording.
Oh, right. Hello and welcome to The Mill. I am your host, Dusty Crane, and this week we are definitely not talking about Wingspan. Kind of want to talk about Wingspan. Right, listen, we're doing it anyway, all right? I'm going to provide you with some updates on what Jamie has kind of been progressively showing us as a part of this soft launch to Wingspan. And then we're going to talk about another tease that he's done. Then we're going to talk about some user-made stuff. So we're going to kind of cross the gambit, and let's just gambit. We're going to go ahead and cover a lot of topics, okay? Let's just get right to it. So I mentioned Wingspan. I was sitting here and I was thinking, I have to do a video for Saturday, and what am I going to do? My mind has been obsessed with Wingspan. It continues to look great, but I can't talk about the same thing 2 weeks in a row. I mean, I guess it turns out that I can, because there's more news that keeps coming out. So I didn't post it as a part of my regular subscription because I was just testing some new equipment, but I did post a 1 minute video and another part of the channel there called One More Thing. I don't know if that's going to be a normal thing or not. I just wanted to test some things, but Jamie had revealed a new piece of Wingspan, and that was the bird food dice tower. It's a pretty cool piece of cardboard here. I'll go ahead and show it one of these corners. We're testing some different things this week too, so I'm pointing. I don't know if you can see it. We'll see later, but birdhouse dice tower is one of the things revealed. He also showed the next day there are 170 unique bird cards in Wingspan, and those look something like this. These are mostly North American birds. That question's come up in BGG and in the forums a couple of times. And, well, I got a cat in my lap. I'm talking about birds. Here comes the cat, I guess. So this is Mario. He might not be in focus, but if I mess around with him, sometimes he leaves. But maybe he won't. I don't know. We'll see. So anyway, the 170 unique bird cards represent a lot of North American birds. Not a lot of around the globe birds or around the world birds, but those are coming in expansions. Elizabeth and Jamie have both indicated the desire to work on expansions. There's a forum on BGG in the Wingspan area that says, what birds do you want to see? So if there's any non-North American birds that you are interested in seeing, make sure you pop in there and bring those up. Elizabeth said she started with North American birds because that was what she was most familiar with, and so, I mean, that makes sense. So 170 unique birds with different wingspans and different eggs and different nesting areas and that kind of thing based on those cards. So that was one thing that Jamie showed. We also have a custom game trays insert, which has kind of become a thing with Stonemaier. We have a kind of a unique game tray where it holds the cards for storage, the bird cards and some of the other things that are going to be revealed, holds those and stores them, but it also is a card tray. So at any given time, it looks like there's about three birds that are available to bring into your aviary. There's actual slots on the top of that custom game tray that accommodates that. The next thing revealed is there's automa in this game. You can play single player. Now, we kind of got that with talking about the player count or the player count. We discovered it was 1 to 5. And so there is a automa as a part of this, and it was done by David over at Team Automa. I have not got a chance to look at that or anything. It's still something that's being teased out, but I mean, Team Automa is pretty reliable at creating great single-player experiences, and so I really don't have any doubt that it's going to be the same thing for Wingspan. The next reveal was the player mat. This player mat is pretty large. It's not like game board large, but it's pretty large, and it folds in half. The art was done, I believe it was the entire art was done by Beth Sobel, but it may be just the back. I think it's the entire thing, but when it folds up, it looks like a leather field journal. It's really sharp looking. It looks like, you know, leather and stitching. And then when you open it up, you kind of see, it looks kind of like I guess the bird habitat or the aviary habitat. You have three individual rows there with actions you can take. And again, that looks gorgeous, just like all the art in the game so far has. The reveal that came next was bonus cards. And so Jamie told kind of an interesting story about that. It popped up in, you can see it on Stonemaier's website in the design journals or on the Facebook Wingspan group. We talked about it, but there are bonus cards, and it just says, you know, just give you an idea of what you can work towards in your aviary. Maybe you have so many eggs, or maybe you have birds that their names have colors in them, that type of thing. And so it's not necessarily something you have to do. It's a bonus. Now, one of the things that Jamie mentioned in that design diary that I thought was interesting was originally they were called goal cards. And because they were goals, people identified them as something they had to work towards. And so they were really restricting themselves to the cards when the cards, the points you get for completing them are not, you know, the end all be all. It's not a massive amount of points. And so Jamie and the playtesters had found that the goal cards were actually kind of changing that gameplay experience for the negative. And so they changed it to bonus cards, and that kind of got people's minds working in a different way. And, you know, there's something you can work towards or not work towards. And just that name change, I thought was interesting how it kind of changes the way we think about things. So that was one of the reveals. The latest reveal as of right now, which is Friday, while I'm filming, so I don't know what he's going to reveal tomorrow, if anything, but it was just like cubes, the little cubes or markers that you keep track of things on your mat. As the gameplay goes on, you have less of these markers that indicate a turn or an action you can take. The whole idea is at the beginning of the game, when your mat is not particularly powerful, you want to take more actions. But towards the end of the game, you're doing more things, they kind of chain together, you've got your engine built, and so you don't need as many actions to get as much stuff done. So it's one of those where you're moving these cubes from one place to another, so you have less turns, but you're also getting more done, and you just get the fact that your engine is built, hopefully well, will take care of the fact that you don't have as many actions to take. And so I thought that was pretty interesting. That's my Wingspan news. It's more than even I thought it was going to take up, but we're not just talking about Wingspan. We are also talking about Euphoria. Why are we talking Euphoria? Because Jamie posted a teaser image on his Instagram with this image right here. We see a balloon, a blimp moving over the city, presumably of Euphoria, and we have just kind of the bottom right-hand corner of the box. You see the Stonemaier watermark, but you also see Team Automa's logo there on the box. We knew that this was something that Morton was working on, the one-player option, the one-player Automa, and we've seen a few of the playtesters mention in the Euphoria group that the Automa works really good. And I agree. I did get a chance to playtest that. The Automa is great, but now I think we can talk about it a little bit, just that it exists, because Team Automa's logo is there on the box. And so this is the Euphoria expansion, right? The name hasn't been revealed. Morton has mentioned the name in BGG. Now, whether or not that sticks or whether it goes, it was at the time they were working on it, ignorance is bliss, but I don't know. It could be different. What do you think? Is it going to be changed? Or are we sticking with ignorance is bliss? It's pretty good for a dystopian future, right? That was the Euphoria news. We have that blimp, and someone had mentioned, it's Scythe meets Euphoria. But the blimps were already in Euphoria. The Icarites have those balloons that hang over the city. And so the Icarites did it first. The Euphoria did it first. The Wind Gambit was second. And so that Instagram user that had mentioned it's Scythe comes to Euphoria, it was actually the other way around. It was Euphoria came to Scythe. So the Icarites, it's kind of hard to tell in the image, but you can see their trademark, their symbol, their faction logo, the eye there on the side of that balloon. I think it's a very, 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 I think it's practically positive that it is Euphoria, and it is the expansion. So there's that piece. I'm not going to let you go too terribly long without Scythe news. I know Scythe is near and dear to a lot of our hearts, and so let's talk a little bit about Scythe. We haven't had any news lately on the modular board, with the exception of, and this is kind of a big one, but in the Scythe Facebook group, we were kind of talking about the modular board. We were kind of talking about how Jamie is having his graphic designer work on that modular board, and then Jakub is going to go ahead and do some cleanup. Well, Jakub spoke up in the Facebook group and said he's actually been doing a lot of painting for this, that he has been very busy, that it made it sound in his comments that it was not just a kind of a cleanup role. It sounded like he was doing a lot of painting and for a couple of days in a row. I don't know from an artist perspective, like, is a couple of days in a row painting, is this massive? Did he take care of all the boards? Is this like one hex? I don't know, but the fact that Jakub indicated that he was heavily involved again is probably great news for anyone who is worried, who loves Scythe and that art style already. Jakub seems to be back in the saddle. I think that's great news. The other piece of Scythe news that I have for you is kind of related to the modular board. We talked about the possibility of the inclusion of bonus tiles. These are the building bonus tiles, and these are the, you know, if you build your structures in such a way, this is a bonus that you will get. It was we've seen his mods come up on the show before. Mihir Shah has shared some bonus structure tiles and got a response from Jamie. He presented like four. Jamie mentioned that the first two were actually particularly of interest to him. And so I'm gonna pop those up right here for you to look at. The first one is building structures kind of in a diamond, right? There are some rules, like you can't use the areas that are adjacent to your home base. Where you're building these buildings is a 2, 4, 6, or 9 bonus. Now that can be reworked and that can be adjusted, but that is tile one, is building in a diamond pattern. The second tile that was created is right here, and this one is a structure bonus for building around an encounter territory. Now, I think when you can move on to the encounter, you can take the encounter, just being on the territory itself, building around it. There's a 2, 4, 6, and 9 bonus. And again, this is one of those situations where those values could be adjusted if the playtesting goes well. What I thought would be particularly interesting, there's a couple of other tiles here that I really liked, but they could be kind of mean if you were, you know, spending the resources to build. One of them was build around the leader. And that one was, you know, someone's like, well, there's your impetus to attack their character on the last turn so they don't get that building bonus. And I mean, a 9-point hit or 9-coin hit if you had done the full building is kind of painful. But yeah, there's actually a lot of these bonus tiles that are popping up in the variance board on BGG, and I'm just curious if you've made any yourself or if you have played with any of them yourself. If you haven't and you're curious, like Jamie had mentioned, like Mihir had mentioned, that really take a look at this forum or this particular first two tiles. I'll go ahead and toss those in the comments. Give those two a shot, the building in a diamond pattern and the building around an encounter token. Just let them know how that affected your gameplay, if that was a great building bonus tile, or if maybe you encountered some kind of issue, or maybe there's some kind of imbalance, maybe one faction has an advantage over another. They need to know all that for playtesting, so be sure if you try it to speak up and let them know what you find. That is really all I have for you this week. The Wingspan news continues to that train just continues to carry on. Jamie did mention that it's not going to be a daily reveal like it has been, that this is just kind of early. And so once we get closer to, I guess, the holidays here, people are busy. You're not necessarily watching board game news on the daily. And so that'll slow down. Jamie's got a trip planned to the Survivor Final in California. And so he'll be busy over there. So we may just not, those updates are going to slow. That actually did remind me of one more thing I wanted to bring up. People have asked about the pre-orders. The game goes for sale for pre-order on January 2nd. Now, the game is already in the warehouse. And so what's going to happen is once the game goes on pre-order, Stonemaier Champions, if you are one, those are going to start shipping right away. If you're not a Stonemaier Champion, take a look at the program, see if it's something that interests you. Off the top of my head, I think it's $12 a year. It helps Jamie pay for the videos he makes, the blogs he makes, the Kickstarter information that he continually produces. You also get the benefit of early releases from if you buy directly from the Stonemaier store. So that's something that you might want to take a look at, because as I mentioned, Wingspan is going to go out to Stonemaier Champions immediately after that January 2nd window opens. A few weeks later, maybe a couple weeks later, a few weeks later, if you ordered from Stonemaier shops, then that game is going to go out to you at that point, whether or not you're a champion or not. And then it's going to be a few months before this is available in retail. So if Wingspan is looking good and you're on that hype train and you want to get it ASAP, going and ordering it through Stonemaier is probably the way to go. Questions for you guys or gals that I would love to hear would be, now that more and more has come out about Wingspan, are you still excited? Has your excitement grown? Has it kind of fallen off? Was it different than you thought it might be? The second question is, are you hyped for the Euphoria expansion? Are you excited for an Automa for Euphoria? Is that something you think the game was missing? As it relates to Scythe, I'd already asked that question about the bonus tiles. Is that something you've played with before, the variants the fans have created? And are you going to check out these new ones? Finally, if you like what we're doing here, like and subscribe, and drop me a comment. Let me know what Stonemaier news has got you excited this week. Until then, thank you for watching, and I will talk to you later.